8th standard students, so from this video I am going to start with your revision part. In the revision part we have started with the first topic, that is practical geometry. We have completed with your syllabus practical geometry, data handling, and one more topic, that is mensuration, then exponents and powers, direct and inverse proportion, and factorization. So these are the six topics for your annual examination. That is, first one is practical geometry, second one is data handling, third one you are having as mensuration, fourth one exponents and powers, and fifth one is direct and inverse proportion and factorization. So these are the six topics for your annual examination. So revision, I am going to start with the exponents and powers. So see here, first question in the revision part. So see here, find m so that 3, that is minus 3 whole raised to m plus 1 into minus 3 whole raised to 5 is equals to minus 3 whole raised to 7. So this is your question. So just I will write the given thing. That is, given thing, minus 3 whole raised to m plus 1 into minus 3 whole raised to 5 is equals to minus 3 whole raised to 7. So this is your given thing. So see here, we have to use the formula as a raised to m into a raised to n is equals to a raised to m plus n. So see the LHS part, we have to use the apply the formula a raised to m into a raised to n is equals to a raised to m plus n. So see here, minus 3, minus, if both the bases are same, just we have to add the exponents, that is m plus 1 plus of 5 is equals to minus 3 whole raised to 7. Okay, so see here, minus 3, first thing is minus 3 whole raised to m plus 1 into minus 3 whole raised to 5 is equals to minus 3 whole raised to 7. Okay, so we are using the formula as a raised to m into a raised to n is equals to a raised to m plus n. So minus 3 whole raised to m plus 1 plus 5. So both the bases are same, means we have to add only the powers. M plus 1 plus 5 is equals to minus 3 whole raised to 7. Okay, so see here, if you add this, see the LHS part, that is minus 3, that is 1 plus 5, that is you get as M plus minus 3 whole raised to M plus 6 is equals to minus 3 whole raised to 7. Now see, are the both the sides powers have the same base, different from 1 and minus 1, so their exponents must be equal. So see here, both the sides, the bases are same and powers have the same, just equate the powers, so that is you will get as m plus 6 is equals to 7. So you will get as m is equals to 7 minus 6. So m is equals to 7 minus 6 means m is equals to, you will get as 1. I hope so you understood this problem. That is, m is equals to 1. So see here, one more question. Find the value of, that is, a1 you are having 2 raised to minus 3, b1 you are having 1 divided by 3 raised to minus 2. Okay, so see here, 2 raised to minus 3. So given first thing, 2 raised to minus 3. This 2 raised to minus 3, so this, the power is in the form of negative. First you convert, it is in the form of positive. So that is 1 divided by 2 raised to 3. So 1 divided by 2 raised to 3, if I do, that is 1 divided by 2 into 2 into 2, which is equals to 1 divided by 8. Similarly, so this is your required answer, that is 2 raised to minus 3 you are having as 1 divided by 8. Similarly, B question, if you go for B question you are having as 1 divided by 3 raised to minus 2. So 1 divided by 3 raised to minus 2, that is you will get as, so make this is in the form of negative, make this positive by shifting to numerator. It is in the form of denominator, so make 3 raised to minus 2 is equals to 3 raised to 2. So that is 3 into 3, which is equals to 9. 3 into 3 is equals to 9. So this is the required answer. So now see, simplify 1 by 3 raised to minus 2 minus of 1 by 2 raised to minus 3 divided by 1 by 4 raised to minus 2. Okay, so see here, first problem we will take, that is 1 by 3 whole raised to minus 2 minus of 1 by 2 raised to minus 3 divided by 1 by 4 So now see 1 by 3 whole raised to minus 2 minus of 1 by 2 whole raised to minus 3 divided by 1 by 4 raised to minus 2. Okay, now see here we have to apply 1 into whole raised to minus 2, you will get as 1 raised to minus 2 divided by 3 by 3 raised to minus 2 minus of 1 raised to minus 3 whole divided by 2 raised to minus 3 whole divided by 1 raised to minus 2 whole divided by 1 divided by, that is 4 raised to minus 2. Okay, so see here once again we have to multiply this 1 into minus 2, that is 1 raised to minus 2, 3 raised to minus 2 divided by 3 raised to minus 2 minus of 1 raised to minus 3 divided by 2 raised to minus 3 whole divided by 1 raised to minus 2 divided by 4 raised to minus 2. Okay, now you see, just we have to take the reciprocal. First, this is in the form of, the power is in the form of negative. So first you have to make it is in the form of positive. So write this as 3 raised to 2 divided by 1 raised to 2 minus 2 raised to 3 divided by 1 raised to 3. Okay, so whole divided by, this is 4 raised to 2 whole divided by 1 raised to 2. Okay, now see 3 square is, that is 3 into 3 which is equals to 9 minus of 2 raised to 3, 2 raised to 3 is 8 whole divided by 1 whole divided by 4 square is 16 divided by 1. So this 1 and this 1 get cancelled. So remaining is 9 minus 8. So 9 minus 8 is 1 divided by 16. So this is your required answer. Okay, so see here once again 1 by 3 whole raised to minus 2 minus of whole, that is into 1 by 2 whole raised to minus 3 divided by 1 by 4 whole raised to minus 2. So see here, this I have to multiply separately in the numerator as well as denominator. So 1 raised to minus 2 divided by 3 raised to minus 2 minus of 1 raised to minus 3 divided by 2 raised to minus 3 whole divided by 1 raised to minus 2 divided by 4 raised to minus 2. So first, this, the powers are in the form of negative, so just make this positive by taking the reciprocal. 3 raised to 2 divided by 1 raised to 2 minus of 2 raised to 3 divided by 1 raised to 3 whole divided by 4 raised to 2 divided by 1 raised to 2. So 3 square is 9 minus 2 raised to 3, that is, which is equals to 8. 9 minus 8 whole divided by 1 and 4 square is 16 by 1, 1 get cancelled. So remaining is 9 minus 8 which is equals to 1 divided by 16. I hope so you understood this problem. Second one, you are having the problem as second one, that is 5 by 8 whole raised to minus 7 into 8 by 5 whole raised to minus 5. So similarly, again this you have to multiply separately in the numerator and denominator. 5 raised to minus 7 divided by 8 raised to minus 7 into 8 raised to minus 5 divided by 5 raised to minus 4. So just you have to make some adjustment, that is 5 raised to minus 7 whole divided by, this you take to this side, 5 raised to minus 5 into 8 raised to minus 5 whole divided by 8 raised to minus 7. Now you have to use the formula as a raised to m divided by a raised to n is equals to a raised to m minus n. Okay, so see here now, it is 5 minus 7 minus of minus 5 into 8 into, that is, minus 5 minus of minus 7. Okay, so this will get, we have, if you apply this formula, that is 5 minus 7, as it is, minus into minus is plus 5 into 8 raised to minus 5 minus into minus is again plus 7. Okay, now see, minus 7 plus 5 will get as 5 raised to minus 2 into 8 raised to 7 minus 5 is 8 raised to 2. So now see, 8 raised to 2, this is 5 raised to minus 2, it is in the form of negative, so just make this as positive, this 5 raised to 2. So 8 square you are having as 64 and 5 square you are having as 25. So this is your required answer. Once again see here, 5 by 8 whole raised to minus 7 into 8 by 5 whole raised to minus 5. So 5 multiply with both numerator and 8 you multiply with denominator. So 5 raised to minus 7 divided by 8 raised to minus 7 into 8 raised to minus 5 divided by 5 raised to minus 5. So 5 raised to minus 7, 5 divided by 5 raised to minus 7 into 8 raised to minus 5 divided by 8 raised to minus 7. We have to use the formula as, that is a raised to m in divided by a raised to n is equals to a raised to m minus n. So 5 raised to minus 7 you have to keep as it is. So this, when if you apply this formula, minus sign, we have to keep this as it is, into bracket you have to write as this as minus 5 into 8 raised to minus 5 minus into minus of 7. So 5 minus 7 plus 5, 8 raised to minus 5 plus 7. So 7 minus 5 is 2, by keeping the greater number sign, you have to keep the sign, into 8 raised to 2, 7 minus 5 is 2. So 8 raised to 2 as it is 5 raised to minus 2, whole divided by 5 raised to 2. So 8 square is 64, 5 square is 25. So I hope so you understood this exponents and powers, that is first part of this revision. Second part will solve in your next video. For this, first all of you just go through these examples and just practice in your home. Thank you.